Hey everyone, I'm Aaron the Toy Enhancer and welcome to the channel. I wanted to do something special for reaching 1,000 subscribers. I know we have surpassed 1,000 since then, but when I hit the 1,000 subscribers, I was really busy with doing YouTube interviews, making content. I had a lot of customs going on and a few dioramas that I just had to finish up, but I finally got a chance to give you guys a little tour, and today we're gonna take a look at my classified collection. I got a little bench there so I can hop up, and we're gonna go up to the top and we're gonna take a look. I know you guys see this on my G.I. Joe reviews, G.I. Joe classified reviews, but we're gonna take a little tour. Let me climb up here. We'll start over here. This is where I keep my 00 Snake in the box. I only have one of them. And I keep my Berserker Bear there for Memory Toys. Thank you, Articulated Ninja, for reviewing that. That's why I picked it up. And I love the Berserker Bear. So again, thank you, Ninja. I probably wouldn't have picked it up if it wasn't for you and Hatter showing that. Over here, we're coming up to my Custom Mechs. They've been in the field a lot, so I have a little repair work. You can see a light is busted on one, and a grill is laying inside of it. Came out during I just shuffle them to the woods a lot, so yeah, I gotta make some repairs on them. You know how it is with customs, guys. They don't always hold together like perfect, but we'll see if we can get them that way. And then over here on my shelving, we'll start off with some Trouble Bubbles, Zaymont and Tomax in prime form. We have the first Firefly that we got. Had to have them out here on display. And then we have a cluster of the Dreadnoks that we've received so far. We got Zartan and Copperhead. There's another Trouble Bubble up there. Pythana, the Snow Serpents. I had to put both versions up there, one with the headdress of the wolf dress. Then we have some more Python Patrol with Copperhead, because he was the leader of Python Patrol. We have the bat in there. It's a Red Ninja, Mole Rat. Of course, I have my boy Scrap Iron. Can't forget about Scrap Iron. Got to have him out here for Down South 77. We have the old Cobra Commander in the back there. Just chilling, set aside. Here's the new Firefly, which I love them both. If you were to ask me to pick between the two Fireflies that we have, well, I'm not sure I could. I love them both. Python Patrol, Trouble Bubble. Here we have my Serpentor, which let me know if you guys had this same issue in the comments, please. You see how his waist is all jacked up and there's a big, huge gap in it? Let me know if you had that problem with your Serpentor. I have another Serpentor in the box, and I'm scared to even open it because I don't want to see that happen again, but Hasbro never got back to me on the QC issue with that. They never responded back to my email. Up here is a picture that my wife did a long time ago when I first started collecting. She painted that by hand, so I keep it, I cherish it. My wife made it. Here we have Storm Shadow and Mickey Mouse, Cobra Commander with his golden cobras. this is me. No, it's the Cobra Officer. This is what I cosplay when we go to places like Joe Fest and Dragon Con. Of course, got to have the Croc Master out. Destro and Baroness together. Back there is just the package to my Mickey Mouse. I just had to set it next to it. Another Trouble Bubble. Got all kinds of Trouble Bubbles. I've got a few I still need to open. Some Valkyrie. Televipers. Some Cobra Troopers. I have some Vipers here, along with the Ninja Viper I made. I had to have him up here. I love the Ninja Viper. Put some claws on his gauntlets there so he could shred into things. Of course, we had the original Bat. That's the guy that probably him and the Alley Viper really got me into Classified. And I don't believe, yeah, oh, here we go. I do have an Alley Viper out. So the Bat and the Alley Viper are what really sucked me in when they first came out. And I was like, okay, I'm going in on the line. I gotta go in on this line. We have Shadow Tracker, Range Viper, and here's the Crimson Team, the Vipers and the Guards, Alley Viper, Crimson Strike Team, and the Bat. And then over here is the custom Chevy that I did. Everyone seemed to really like this. A few people tried to buy it off me and wanted me to make them one. We'll see. I'll see if I can do that. I know nobody's really seen the seat. There's a little detail on the seat, and the turret spins all the way around. You get a full 360 spin. And that gun can shoot anywhere, way up in the sky, or down 10 feet from the truck. So it's real versatile. Here's what it looks like next to a his tank. So it looks size, the size is good. It's just a little smaller than the his tank, which it should be. And then we'll come down here. I have the Joes just in random shelves. See how good the lighting will come in. And yes, my Cobras are on the top shelf because I love Cobra so much. I like G.I. Joe, period, but I'm a big Cobra fan. So you see, we have Chuckles and Helix. Breaker's back there. Snow Job, Shipwreck. Wolf Spider, Shockwave. Here we have some Tiger Force, along with Desert Commando, Snake Eyes. You got Tunnel Rat in there. Torpedo. Steel Brigade. Here's another his tank with the strike team, fire team. Got a random Viper just sitting right here, just chilling. There's another group of Joes. There's Lady J and Snake Eyes. I think Snake Eyes is just in about every pocket because we have so many of them, and I love Snake Eyes. Cover Girl, got Grunt in there, Flint, Gung Ho, Big Ben, Mutton Junkyard, over here we got Low Light, Beachhead, he's just chilling by the sandbags, Slaughter. Yeah, Jody Shooter, Rock and Roll, Hawk, Dusty, Snake Eyes, Stalker. So let me hop off the bench here. Kind of pull it out of the way. I know what you're thinking. You're like, Aaron, not all the Joes and Cobras are out. I know. I haven't opened everything yet. I started the channel somewhere around number 67, and then we basically did everything, you know, there on. I have opened up a few, you know, before I started the channel, so they never really got reviewed, and there's some that I've never opened, like my Zartan 31, number one Roadblock. Well, most of them guys I haven't even opened. My Regal, Cobra, the variant I haven't opened. But yeah, there's a lot of people in here. That Roadblock I haven't opened yet. I haven't opened the Baroness, haven't opened Storm Shadow. There's a lot. Pimp Daddy Destro. So if you're like, oh, some figures are missing, especially Mindbender, he's right here. Number 43. I just haven't opened them yet. I'm gonna open Mindbender. And we're gonna save these other figs for just rainy day reviews. I know they've already been reviewed hundreds of times by other people, but I will get to them. I do have every figure that has come out, and then the Vamp, it will be here in a day or two, and some more figs are on their way. But yeah, this is a open box and mitten box collection. I have everything all tied into this room. We'll take a little step back here, see if I can keep out of the computer area. And everything's all tied in to one light, so I can just flick a switch and it's off. Everything's off. I can just flick the switch back on. Boom. We're booted back up. So real easy to come in here and just, you know, admire my collection. This is my bedroom, so do have a little bed there, and I get to lay down and look at my figs and think about my next custom or what I want to do next. There's a bunch of vintage over here. This is another thing that people were asking about. Where do you keep all your accessories and stuff? Obviously, everybody doesn't hold their accessories. And I like to keep mine just in these bins. And stuff's kind of been scattered, you know. But you can see, you know, for the most part, because it kind of jumps around from them being shooken and stuff. But this is how I store all my extra parts to my G.I. Joe Classified. So if I'm doing a certain scene, or I need a missile, or an effect, or just anything, a pair of binoculars, you know, you never know what you need when you're doing photo shots. It's easy to just go into these boxes and find the accessories that I need. Like I said, they're not all 100%, but because I've been in and out of my boxes so much, but you can see all the extra accessories that I acquire. And I find that's the easiest way to keep things handy. And you know, I got another box here that we're working on filling up. It's just full of Viper rifles and whatnot. And then we have a couple more boxes, but yeah, that's what I keep them in. And it's real handy. So let me know what you guys think, and let me know about your classified collections. And do you collect mint in box? Do you open your figs? What do you prefer? And we're just going to see this collection grow over the next few years. And we'll clear out some more space. I'll probably end up moving the vintage into a whole nother room, because I already have my vintage figs put up. I'm making special cases for them that get mounted to the wall. I'm still working on those. but I'm probably going to end up splitting up my Joe collection eventually. And we'll have one vintage room and then one classified room. And then I have my other toys in the mix, my Turtles and Thundercats. And there's one that's been sitting here for a while. He just hit the review table, so we'll get him reviewed for you guys. All right, everyone. Give a like, give a share, leave some comments, subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next time.